and welcome to Nutrition Therapy by Lucy. This is a channel who talk about food, good nutrition, and health. Thank you for your support, for always watching my videos, leaving a comment, giving them a like. I am so grateful, even for subscribing to this channel. But if you're here for the first time, please make sure you hit on that subscribe button, the red button. We get to learn all together. For the new subscribers, karibu sana, feel welcome. Here we talk all matters nutrition and health to make sure that we have a healthy lifestyle. So welcome to yet another episode of Nutrition and Fitness During Pregnancy. And as you can see, we are having a sit down. We are going to talk all matters nutrition and fitness. We had videos how you can work out your first trimester, second and third. But now we are going to concentrate more on theory, little bit. As you can see, I'm not alone. I have with me the Mokazi's Fitness. He's been taking us through all those workouts, and we have our model, the Rumus family, and also their YouTubers. I will pin their link, the YouTube link, on my comment section. Make sure you go check them out, show some love and subscribe to their channel, because you want to learn from each other. So karibu sana, and let's get to learn together. Yes.
How important is nutrition before pregnancy? Because it's important for not so many people get pregnant by accident. Most people plan for it. So how important is nutrition before pregnancy, during the first trimester, the second trimester, and the third trimester, and after pregnancy?
Nutrition is very key before pregnancy, because you are preparing your body to carry a whole human being. So you need to check your age. If you are overweight, obese, this is the time that you consider maybe going to consider maybe shedding some kg. So your weight is very important, and also your vitamins and minerals. So this is the point that if you are not maybe consuming the fruits and vegetables, this is the point that you need to incorporate more in your diet. So make sure you check your weight, let it be in that desirable range, and also make sure that you are eating healthy, because you're preparing your body. Then when it comes to maybe the first trimester, this is now the after conceiving, they are mostly, we call them the three major nutrients that your body requires. This is the iron, folic acid, and calcium. For the iron, you need to have a healthy hemoglobin level. I think after you go for your checkup, the first, I think you can confirm this, after going for the first clinic, your blood samples are taken, you check your hemoglobin, your blood group, and hemoglobin is very important. Remember, hemoglobin is the one that helps to carry oxygen all around the body. So if you have a low hemoglobin level, that means there can be some oxygen deficit, which is not healthy for you, and also not healthy for your baby. Then we need a nutrient like the folic acid or vitamin B9. You need it in the first 28 days of pregnancy. Remember, the first 28 days of pregnancy, you're not even sure whether you're pregnant. So this tells you how important it is to take folic acid supplements before pregnancy. But don't do just over the counter. Consult your gyna, consult your doctor, tell them you're planning to get pregnant, and they can prescribe the best vitamin B9 or the folic acid for you. Then of course you need the importance of the folic acid the first 28 days. It is to prevent development of the neurotube defects. We have the spina bifida, which is very common. So you need your folic acid before pregnancy and after pregnancy in the first 28 days. Then of course we have the calcium. You need it for your bones and also for the baby. If you don't have enough calcium stores, the baby will drain everything from you. And that's why you find mostly during pregnancy, your bones are aching, the joints are aching. That means you need calcium. If you're not getting them, you're not getting enough calcium from the foods, you can get the supplement. But as always, when you're pregnant, don't do over-the-counter drugs or the supplements. Consult your doctor, consult your guide, so that they can be able to prescribe that fits your body and your condition. Yes.
Amazing.
So to touch on that, on those supplements, there are those supplements that have calcium and nutrients, and there are those, I don't understand why some people are taking different calcium, nutrient, and I know the other one is just, we are taking the basis, I don't know why, but why can't we get the combined? I know they are combined, but you see some people, like, I think they are overdoing those. The combined one has calcium and nutrients, and the other one, and then they again take different for calcium and nutrients. Do you get my point?
Yeah.
Yeah, like they are taking like a lot of drugs. Like for me, I only take one drug and it has everything. But you find, yes, it has that. You find another one is adding for calcium and adding nutrients in. Why are they doing that? Is it not dangerous?
To touch on that, okay, I don't know why we're directing the question. Next time we bring a doctor here.
Yeah,
so at least we have someone to throw questions.
Yeah. Okay.
Can it be because people react differently to
exactly.
medicine?
Okay.
Because you have people who react differently to medicine. That's why we may have the combined for the person who is okay with any. And we have people who react to certain components in the medicine, so they have to be given specifically, individually separately.
And maybe also, you might not be having problems with your calcium level.
Mm-hmm.
So you find that you are taking one combined pill that has iron and folic acid, which is very common, the IFAS, we all know that,
yeah.
Which has iron and it has folic acid in it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So you can also do fruits instead of medicine.
Again, in pregnancy, the reason why you do supplements is because the requirements, they are higher, and you cannot be able to meet all these requirements with diet only. So it's important to check your fruits and vegetables, but take your pills, your IFAS, the supplements on a daily basis.
Even for those people who fear medicine, people who fear supplements, so they need to understand supplements are just the same nutrients that you are to get from food,
yeah.
But now in a more refined
it's like direct
nature.
To the
yes
to
so
the
it goes direct to the system,
yes.
Because if I need iron for my body, I may not get enough from the food I'm eating, and that's why even people who are doing bodybuilding, they need supplementation,
yeah.
So there is always a myth between supplements and steroids.
Yeah. That's a good one. I didn't know about that. At least, actually, I have a friend who is not taking supplements. She's doing fruits and vegetables. So I was so concerned. She started doing calcium alone. She was not doing IFAS actually. Now she's not doing. I guess it's because of that reaction towards the medicine.
And also information. Get the right information.
Mm-hmm.
Don't consult. Yes, you can consult your friends,
your
but it's always good to consult
the doctor.
A doctor, yes.
Who actually has your history.
Your history.
They know like your body type.
Yeah.
They know like what you might react on, what you might not react on. So I think it's important that we have.
I do not listen to
me.
Oh
yes,
my God, you will be lost. You will be lost. Because even men tell you what to do and they don't know how.
Pregnancy.
Yes,
we
they
know
about
pregnancy.
But they don't know what you're going under.
Yes.
Yeah. So everyone, like, when you're pregnant, everyone around you is pregnant. He or she will tell you, don't take this, don't take that, don't
start the clinic for
yeah.
4 months.
Yeah. So I think do not follow what people say. These are myths. Don't just do you, because it's your own journey and people are so different. Actually, people are so different. So I have a question for Lucy about food. Like in first trimester, we are being told, again, it's a myth. Remember this video we're talking about myth. Again, it's a myth. You're being told, like, do not take liver, do not take pineapple, do not take papaya. What else? Do not take cork because of the gas. So is it true about all these foods? Fruits, drinks, because people will mislead you. Trust me, when you're pregnant, people will mislead you. People will tell you, take a lot of
cock.
Cock.
your child will come out
brown. Yeah, your child will be so brown and clean. Sure. And it's a whole, I'm sorry to say, it's a man telling you that. You find a woman telling you, don't take pineapple. Pineapples, I don't
need you slender.
Yeah, we. It's a lot of meat.
Don't take bananas.
Don't take bananas. Potential. Yes.
Take the egg, you grow fat.
Don't take a.
Actually, that's true.
It is
someone,
true.
Someone, I had someone telling a pregnant, if you take a lot of eggs, you are the baby is growing fast.
It's not good to deliver. No.
Yes, so don't grow the baby from inside.
Inside, yeah.
And wait until it's out, then you can.
Me. And another one was saying, don't take avocado. Because that was the funniest. The head of the baby will be big.
Wow.
You not. It is true. You not deliver normal because you are taking a lot of avocados. So you should minimize on that actually. Actually means
basically meat. Don't take anything.
Don't take anything. Basically do water and greens.
Exactly.
So Lucy, can you tell us? Are we supposed not to take those fruits and vegetables and greens? Like how true is it?
Let me can start with the most common with the foods. For example, you hear that don't take an egg, your baby will grow extra big. That's a lie. An egg is not unless you are overdoing it, but if you're doing maybe twice or thrice a week, it is very healthy. Because again, egg, you're benefiting from all the nutrients.
Yeah.
Egg is a complete nutrient, meaning that you have all the amino acids that your body requires. And also, an egg, it has a very important nutrient, choline, which will help in brain development of the baby. So an egg, if you stop taking an egg because of those meat, please, it's a lie. An egg a day is very healthy. As long as you're doing it healthy, you can do on alternate days or you can do twice a week. Any food like the pineapples, the dates, most pregnant moms, they take them in the third trimester. Because there is a meat that go around,
which induces
induced. And it's a complete lie. Take them for their benefits, for their nutritional value, but they won't induce labor. To induce labor, get active, talk to the mother's fitness. But for the pineapples and labor, it's a lie. And also, maybe for such food to have effect, maybe not unless you're taking a sack of pineapples, a whole sack of dates, but they won't induce labor. But take them for their nutritional value. Then you touched on taking liver. Liver is not recommended to take during pregnancy.
Sorry?
You're not supposed to take liver when you're pregnant. And this is the reason. Liver, it contains proactive vitamin A, which are shown to have some bad effect on development. So a liver, as much as it's very high in iron, it is not good choice for any pregnant mother. So obtain your iron from the IFAS, obtain your iron from the lean red meat, from the leafy green vegetables, but your liver, just leave it there, you're going to enjoy it after the pregnancy to replenish the lost blood. Yes.
So you have had.
Yes.
That's a good one. I didn't know about that. I've been taking liver, but not much. Again, about fruits, my husband brought me papaya and I'm like, no, I'll not eat. Because I was influenced, papaya is not good. Again, also pineapple, I was influenced. I should take it on my third trimester. Now at least we know, and again, these are myths. Meat.
If you have more myths, kindly write on the comment section below.
Yeah, what is that you had maybe about pineapples? Did you even come here to Rika?
Yeah, I know.
During your third trimester,
just have enough of the pineapples. But it's a meat, take them for their nutritional value, for the benefits, because you get all the nutrients, the vitamin C, the potassium, but don't eat them and you expect that they owe you a normal delivery. They won't.
And what about alcohol? Guinness. Kunywa Guinness. Kunywa Guinness itosha mtoto. Kunywa Guinness mtoto atatoka.
Pure clean.
Clean. Kunywa Guinness utakuwa na labor. Kunywa Guinness. How true is that? And why Guinness actually?
Okay, You can ask my time why it is and not any other.
Yeah, not Tasca, not.
Plus, alcohol is associated with the fetal syndrome. Called alcohol fetal syndrome. It can come in there with some cognitive disability, physical disabilities, and also alcohol is associated with low birth weight and sometimes even stillbirth, giving birth to a dead baby. And this is not something you can't even, something not even you want to imagine. So alcohol, when the king is sweet, the baby will come out. Remember, we talk about amniotic fluid.
Yeah.
So how do you want to tell me that now the Guinness will replace the amniotic fluid? That's a complete lie. The baby will come up with the whitish skin, but with time the skin will appear. Yes. And I hope you've learned something. First trimester, second trimester, third trimester, all concerning nutrition and fitness. And wakazi, ametupeleka vizuri the journey, how to do it and how not to do it. I will link the nutrition link on my comment section. I will pin it, and also I'll pin the Lungu's family YouTube channel so that you can be able to interact with them. You can ask him as many questions, and also you can interact with the Lungu's family to take them, they can share their journey on pregnancy. So get interactive in the comment section, give this video a like, share widely, and turn on the notification bell so that anytime you upload an educative video like this one, you get to get notified. So thank you, and let me get to see you on my next video.